Welcome to this week's Power of Possible, brought to you by UConn Health.
I definitely saw the difference between me and my peers. I thought it was just like freckles or long eyelashes. I didn't really see it as something that made me abnormally different.
Mackenzie was born with a cleft lip and palate. When she was 11, we decided to pursue this skeletal anchorage approach with some plates to minimize that discrepancy between the upper and lower jaw.
Which worked like a charm.
Dr. Uribe is fantastic. He listens to Mackenzie. He always asks, Mackenzie, you okay with that? And, you know, she always says yes.
I think it's because it worked so well. I was like, mucho bueno. My sister Hadley's always been my biggest cheerleader. And
not only does she want to be Mackenzie, she wants cleft lip and palate. Because it's been such a positive experience.
At the end, we have a patient that would likely need surgery with nothing of that. Her result is like unbelievable, outside of this world, yeah.
She's beautiful, you know, she always has been, and to see her, to see her grow into a confident young lady and to be able to give this to her is huge.
Join us next time for Power of Possible, brought to you by UConn Health.